Welcome back. You're watching The Money Show on ET Now, and I'm Alex Matthew. Well, we endeavor on this show to get you a holistic view of how to manage your finances. As part of that, we have a segment called Meet Your Fund Manager. And on that segment, it gives me a lot of pleasure to introduce you to Anirudh Naha, who's a Senior Fund Manager Equity at PGIM India Mutual Fund. Thank you so much, Mr. Naha, for speaking to us here at ET Now, and hopefully we'll get a little bit of insight as to how you're viewing the market. It's been a challenging couple of days, and I think that a lot of retail investors tuning in will want to get a sense from you as to how to view the recent developments, particularly the kind of selling that you saw in the broader markets as well. You handle both the mid-cap as well as the small-cap fund at PGIM. How are you viewing that end of the market and everything else that is happening in the markets right now?
Sure, thank you for having us over. So I think investors need to get ready for some amount of volatility. The last 1 year has been a very easy year for making money. And I guess incrementally, there are going to be challenges with regards to the valuations, how inflation and interest rates play out, and probably how the vaccination program plays out. Hopefully the vaccination program plays out well, the economy opens up. If that happens, our sense is the strength of earnings will be pretty good over the next 2 years. And hence, there will be earnings support, but in some pockets, there is a froth which has built up in terms of valuations. And if earnings disappoint, there could be some amount of correction. So investors need to take a longer time frame from here on. They must have a time frame of about 4 to 5 years and be ready for some amount of volatility.
Now, Mr. Naha, in conversations that we were having during the day, both today and yesterday, a point that our editor was making, Mr. Nikunj Zalmia, was that very rarely do you see a situation in the Indian equity market, and in fact in any market, where you see banks getting sold very heavily as well as metals being sold very heavily. Now the second group is a group that has rallied tremendously in line with what has happened globally because of the underlying commodities, and that is a factor of how the projection or expectation of economic growth is going to be, and banks overall would benefit from a reopening. Is this an indication that there is a little bit of discomfort in the institutional side as well as on the retail side with where the markets have been off late, close to 16,000 for the Nifty 50?
So I think more than the absolute number, I think valuations are what one should need or one needs to look at. Clearly on a valuations front, in the near term, it might look a little stretched. And hence, that was the reason why we think there could be some bout of correction that could happen. Having said that, over the next 2 years, if the earnings play out the way it is expected to, which would be this year and the next year, valuations don't seem that stretched. With regards to financials specifically, we as a house have been a little cautious, especially given the fact that you've got asset quality issues. The second COVID wave has been pretty disastrous, at least for the MSME segment. We are waiting to see how the asset quality plays out. If the asset quality issues are abated, at least the banking system is well capitalized this time around. And hence, probably at some point, you will start seeing the sector coming back. But in the near term, there are going to be challenges with regards to asset quality.
Okay, in terms of allocation, and of course, this would depend from investor to investor, but if you were to say that this is an investor that has a very long horizon ahead of them and has a moderate sort of a risk appetite and a risk-taking capability, assuming that they had a reasonable allocation towards mid-cap and small-cap, the last 4 or 5 months have been incredibly rewarding. And I think a lot of people will have, been a little upset if they had missed out on that kind of rally. What do you anticipate as a manager of funds that focus on this leg or this segment of the market that will happen over the course of the next couple of quarters, especially on the earnings front, do you think that valuations in that segment are very frothy?
So I think earnings strength, without going into the very near term earnings prospects, the earnings prospect for the mid and small caps over the next 1 to 2 years will continue to remain very strong. Having said that, I think investors need to rationalize their expectations. The last 1 year has been an exemplary year, and one should not expect that to get repeated. That is for sure. Even over the next 4 to 5 years, put together, if active fund managers can go ahead and deliver those returns, I think they would have done a good job. So return expectations need to moderate. But having said that, the earnings strength in the mid and small caps over the next 2 to 3 years will remain strong. And in such a scenario, we do not expect a deep correction, frankly speaking. The earnings support should see stocks probably correct a little, but over time start building into the positive territory in terms of returns. So over a period of the next 3-5 years, we remain very positive on how mid and small caps will play out even from here.
Okay. Now, I do want to understand your view on the sectors and what sectors stand out to you. You say as a fund house, you're a little bit cautious on the financial side. And I think from earnings that have already been announced, you have HDFC Bank that had a miss on the asset quality side. Bajaj Finance today talking about asset quality worries. So there are concerns there. But as a fund house, what are you positive on? What sectors are you very bullish on in the near to medium term?
So as a sector, I mean, across our fund house, we've been very positive on IT for the past 1.5 years. Valuations are now getting a little stretched. But having said that, the visibility of earnings in IT will continue to remain strong for the next 12 to 18 months. And hence, in a correction, they will correct less. In a market rally, probably they'll continue to participate. And earnings will continue to surprise positively. That is our expectation on IT. Pharma is another sector where we've been pretty positive on. And that is something where we think it's a most structural play over the next 3 to 4 years. And we continue to like that space. Industrials is another segment where we clearly believe that corporate India today is very deleveraged on their balance sheets. And with demand coming back, there is a decent amount of likelihood of, you know, corporate capex coming back. And if corporate capex comes back, the industrial segment is something which should do well. And finally, a small sector which we think has a good potential is cement, which should continue to show strong numbers in the next few quarters.
Now, you also manage the Balanced Advantage Fund, which is, I think, a great product in that it allows you to be quite nimble with how the equity markets move. What is the strategy that you're adopting in that particular fund?
Sure. So here, our model is such that the fund manager doesn't have the leeway to decide on the equity portion, because then it becomes very subjective. We wanted to bring in objectivity. The model decides on what is the level of equity that needs to be there, depending on where the valuations are. Today, given where the valuations are, we have an exposure of about 30% on equities. Once that is decided, we then go ahead and build the portfolio. Our inclination is still towards IT and pharma in that fund. Financials happen to be an underweight there. Other than that, as I probably some amount of material and some amount of industrials continue to be there. Within the breakup between market caps, we have a decent exposure to large caps out there, which is around about 55 to 60% large caps. The rest is between mid and small caps.
If I ask you specifically about your small cap and your mid cap funds, what is the kind of concentration that you have? Is there a sector that you and you've spoken, of course, about the sectors that you're bullish on, but is there a tendency for a particular type of companies that you're looking at, Mr. Naha?
Yeah, so this is a good question. It gives me an opportunity to talk you through our process to a certain extent. See, we've been a fund house which wants to first reduce mistakes, try and reduce mistakes as far as possible. And what we do is we focus on good operating cash flow generating businesses, and just not in the year which we are evaluating. We go back into the history of a business, and in 70% of the time or 7 out of 10 years, we want positive operating cash flows. The second part is that we want balance sheets which are clean, because clean balance, indebted balance sheets, we've clearly seen businesses find it very difficult to survive. The focus on, you know, clean balance sheets and operating cash flows have helped us reduce a lot of mistakes in the last 3 years. Along with that, we look for businesses where there aren't too many corporate governance issues. These three things act as a safety net for, you know, stocks coming into the portfolio, and they have actually worked very well over the last 3 years, which have been pretty volatile. In the mid cap, we do take some amount of sectoral calls, which is top down. But in the small cap, which is an NFO actually, which is on as of now, and it closes on the 23rd, it will be a complete bottom up approach. And the sectors that get represented will be a fallout of what we select at an individual stock level. The number of stocks in our portfolios are between 40 to 45. At the max, it will go to 50. So if that is the kind of concentration you will see in the portfolios. But our belief is if you like a business, you might as well give it the weightage in a portfolio and let the conviction play out.
You know, I'm curious, and this is obviously something that is perhaps, Mr. Naha, outside of what we had initially thought we would talk about. But what do you think about the new age companies that are making debuts on the stock markets? You have the likes of Zomato that's joining in. You have Paytm that's just around the corner. You have several like Lenskart. You have, the edtech startups that are likely to list. What is your opinion on these high growth companies that are not yet making profits?
Sure. Our opinion as a fund house is companies need to generate cash flows and profits. Finally, that is where it will get valued at over a period of time. And hence, our focus will be unwavering when we look at businesses. They need to generate positive operating cash flows. They need to generate profitability. And that is something that really counts. Personally, I think over the last 5-10 years, interest rates have been on the lower trajectory, and hence we've seen a lot of bubbles getting created across asset classes. We are at a point where one might start seeing interest rates probably move up, not in the next 6 months maybe, but over the next 12 months to 18 months. And there would be some bubbles which will probably pop, and valuations would normalize. And hence, I think the fundamentals need to be very clear before investing into some of these businesses.
Okay, well, it's been an absolute pleasure speaking to you, Mr. Naha. Wish you all the best with that NFO that you said is currently open, and everything else over the course of the next couple of years. Hope to speak to you very soon. Now, the next conversation that